are in groups. The number which we are going to multiply, how many things there are in one group. The number we multiply by tells us how many groups like that we have. Suppose we have the problem 3 times 2. 2 is multiplying. If we are talking about baby chicks, it means that there are 2 chicks in each group. 3 is the number we are multiplying by. It tells us that there are 3 groups. 3 times 2 baby chicks equals 6 baby chicks. Suppose our problem is 2 times 4. And we're talking about marbles. We know that there are 4 marbles in one group, and we have 2 groups. 2 times 4 equals 8. If the problem is 1 times 4, we know that we have our group only one time. 1 times 4 equals 4. Now suppose the problem is 1/2 times 4. How many times do we have this group? We do not have it even one time. We have it only 1/2 a time. So the first thing we must do is divide the group into 2 parts. One of those parts is our answer. 1/2 times 4 equals 2. Suppose our group is 3 discs, and we multiply it by 1/2. The number we are multiplying by is a fraction. The denominator of that fraction is 2. So, we divide our group into 2 parts. Our numerator is 1, so we have only one of those parts in our answer. Our answer is 1/2, or 3/2. Now suppose the number we are multiplying is not a whole number, but is a fraction, such as 1/2. Let's make our problem 1/3 times 1/2. 1/2 is our whole group now. How many times do we have it? Not even one time. We have it only 1/3 of a time. The denominator of the fraction we are multiplying by is 3. So, we have to divide 1/2 into 3 parts. Our numerator is 1, so we have only one of those parts in our answer. Our answer is one of those parts. But how large are those parts? Let's see. Here is our half, which we divided into 3 parts. There is the other half, which would make a complete whole. If we divide that into 3 parts also, we can see the 6 parts in the whole thing. So we know that our parts are 6. And our answer is 1/6. But we cannot work all of our problems by cutting up discs and comparing the size of the parts. We do not have to. There's an easy rule for multiplying fractions. Let's look at the problem we have just worked and discover the rule for ourselves. By cutting up discs, we just saw that 1/3 times 1/2 equals 1/6. We can see that we will have the denominator of the answer if we multiply the denominators of the 2 fractions in our problem together. 3 times 2 equals 6. We know that 1 times 1 equals 1. So, if we multiply the numerators of our problem together, we will have the numerator of our answer. Let's do that again. If we multiply the denominators of our fractions together, we have the denominator of our answer. If we multiply the numerators of our fractions together, we have the numerator of our answer. That is our rule. It's an easy one to remember. Let's look at our disc now. We will discover why the rule is so handy. We will take the problem 1/2 times 3/4. First, let's try to work the problem without using the rule. We will work it the way we did at first, by just finding 1/2 of our group. Here's our group. It's 3/4. If we want to find half of it, We divide it into two parts. We know that one of those parts is our answer. One of the parts is this much. But we cannot write it as a fraction the way it is. The parts are not the same size. And there's nothing to tell us the size of the parts unless we happen to remember them. Our rule does things differently. Here's our problem again. This time we're going to use the rule. The fraction we are going to multiply is 3/4. We are going to multiply it by 1/2. Our rule tells us to multiply the denominators together. What happens when you multiply these denominators together? The original pieces were 4ths. Now they are 2 times as small. Two times 4 equals 8. So now our parts are 8ths. Then we multiply the numerators together. There were 3 parts to start with. The numerator of 1/2 tells us to take 1 part from each of the 3 original pieces. So we have 1 times 3, or 3 parts, for the answer. Our answer is 3/8. You can see that the rule is an easy way to find the answer. Now that we have found our rule and understand it, let's use it to work another problem. Suppose we have the fraction 4/5, and we wish to multiply it by 2/3. Our group is 4/5. We are going to multiply it by 2/3 according to our rule. The denominator of the fraction we are multiplying by is 3. That means that we will divide each part of our group into 3 pieces. The parts were 5ths. These new pieces are 3 times as small. 3 times 5 equals 15. So the new pieces are 15ths. The numerator of the fraction we are multiplying by is 2. So our answer will have 2 pieces from each of the original 4 parts. Two times 4 equals 8. So there will be 8 of the new pieces in our answer. Our answer is 8/15. Now let's use the rule to work a problem at home. Johnny volunteered to paint the new backyard fence. He chose the paint himself and started painting at 1 o'clock. After he had painted 1 hour, his mother stopped him because she didn't like the color he was using. He measured the part he had painted and found that it was 5/8 of the back fence. The next day, he started over again. This time he used white paint. At the end of 3/4 of an hour, he stopped to go on an errand. Now, if he had painted at the same speed on both days, what fraction of the fence had he painted white when he stopped? He had been able to paint 5/8 of the fence in 1 hour. In 3/4 of an hour, he would have painted 3/4 of 5/8 of the fence. How much is 3/4 times 5/8? Fifteen 30 seconds of the fence has it white.